Very good morning to my dear students. So this is Dr. Lakshmi Narasimha Acharyulu, Professor, St. Peter's Engineering College, Hyderabad. Today, I would like to discuss about the RC, RL and NC circuits, which is the very basic preliminaries to do somewhat applications in the transient responses. So in this connection, these transient responses are very much utilized in different applications like design and control systems, and you say that the operating point should be setting, as well as the oscillators, the design and oscillators, the stable oscillators you need to do, like RC and LC oscillators like that. So now we are going to talk about the preliminary things of the RC circuit. That is, this indicates that the RC circuit, this is the charging capacitor. You see here, this is the circuit consists of elements R and C, and the applied voltage, you say that the EMF, you say this is the E, which is indicated like that, and the S is the switch, you say that. The capacitor is in neutral, generally you say that no current flows through the circuit when the switch is open, already know that. So this is the capacitor is charging if you are applying anything. So here the capacitor will be charging through that, the RC circuit charging capacitor, which is the flows like that, which is the yellow marks indicates the flowing. So through the capacitor, which is from the plus Q to the minus Q like that. And you say that the same current is passing through the resistance, which is through R, you say that. So therefore here the switch is closed, for example, the maximum current will flow through this, and you say that the current passing through the circuit, which is indicated by the ratio of the applied voltage to the resistance. If we'll take a RC circuit, the charging capacitor, which is, you say that the plus Q goes the lower part of the capacitor, and the plus Q is repelled from the upper part of the capacitor, leaving a minus Q charge. As the lower plate increases in a positive charge and the plus charge, you say that the current decreases due to the repulsion. So you used to take the repulsion, the same charge quantities is there, then that should be repulsion each other. So, so the same principle is occurs. So therefore you used to take the current decreases due to the repulsion condition. So here the switch is closed here. So therefore the capacitor is charging. When the capacitor is fully charged, then the process repeats until the capacitor gains and the EMF equal to the E and the plates with the charges plus Q and the minus Q. So therefore when the finally the current is zero due to the maximum charge repulsion is there, so therefore then automatically is it should be the maximum charge, which is indicated by Q is equal to CV, or you say that the CE. So therefore the charge across the capacitor, the fully charging, then it indicates that the Q is equal to CV. So the RC circuit charging capacitor, which is the indication is like this, this is the current flows through this, and here R and C, you say that this is, we can write the Kirchhoff's loop, I mean the current law, voltage law, Kirchhoff's voltage law, you say that while you are applying a voltage to this closed circuit, then the applied voltage is equivalent to the sum of the voltage drops across each element in the closed circuit. So therefore here what is the voltage across the capacitor, which is indicated by the Q is equal to CV, that formula, you say that the V is equal to Q by C. And similarly you say that the resistance drop, how much drop across the resistor, which is indicated by I into R here, because I current flows through that. So therefore E minus of whatever the voltage across the capacitor, which is indicated by V suffix C generally. So therefore minus Q by C minus IR, which is equivalent to the zero according to the Kirchhoff's voltage law. So therefore again the charged capacitor, charging the capacitor, you say that. So we can write the Kirchhoff's loop rule or the Kirchhoff's voltage law. You say that which is in the charge quantities we need to take, generally I is equal to dq by dt, already know that the rate of change of charge, so which is called the current. So therefore instead of I, you say the dq by dt. So E minus of Q by C minus dQ by dT into R is equal to 0. So from the Kirchhoff's voltage law, when the switch is closed, so the charging the capacitor, and you again rewrite the equation. So E minus Q by C minus dQ by dT into R, which is equal to 0. A differential equation, you need a better calculus skills, already know that. How you are going to equate this, which is generally used to take dQ by dT into, R should be, you say that division on both sides, then you will get some relation. Just you say, this is generally E minus of Q by C minus dQ by dT into R. So therefore, used to take the Q of T, already you know that, which is the solution has to do, this is the what we call the first order differential equation. So therefore, you may try to do this. This is the Q of T is equal to this CV into of 1 minus e power minus T by RC. So otherwise, you may rewrite the equation Q into of 1 minus e power minus T by RC. So therefore, here just you see that what is the current? Current with of T, I of T is equal to dQ by dT, generally you say that. So therefore, you know that Q of T. So again, you rewrite that. That is Q is equal to what actually? CV. So again, you may calculate this, and you will get the V by R into E power minus T by RC. So here it is current I into E power minus T by RC. But here you say that Q minus Q into E power minus T by RC. So you take, this is the differentiating with respect to the T. So therefore, constant Q, which is equal to 0, and D by DT of E power minus T by RC, which is again the used to take, this is the with respect to that the time. So you may get the Q by RC into E power minus T by RC. So therefore, Q is equal to CV. C and C gets cancelled, so therefore V by R is left, V by R into E power minus T by RC. This is the solution for the current passing through the circuit. So which is indicated by using of this equation, just you have to analyze that, how you are taking here. This is the dQ by dT into R plus Q by C minus E, V is equal to 0. Just will take like that. So therefore, R should be what we call, otherwise you say that the V is equal to Q by C, already you know Q is equal to C V, you know that. The similarly used to take that is in the form of the only C and E or C V, then you will get the first order differential equation. So therefore, here R will be division on both sides, then you will take the V by R minus of Q by C R minus dQ by dT, which is equal to 0. So therefore, again, used to take V by R, which is nothing but I, you say that generally. So you may take only Q here. So by using of solving the complement equation, complementary function, or you say that the auxiliary equation, then we'll get like this. And finally, you found the value of the I of T. And now the RC circuit charging capacitor, which is already know that. So here, how it should be changing with respect to the time, the charge will change with respect to the time. So it is an exponential growth, just you observe that here, which is initiated from the zero level, and which will be T is equal to RC condition. So therefore, it should be increases 0.632 CE, and the maximum is a CE. So that means the T equal to 0 seconds, the charge in capacitor is 0. As the time passes by, charging the capacitor increases up till CV or CE, you say that. So therefore, again, this is the charging of the capacitor, Q into 1 minus E power minus T by RC, where Q is CV, already know that, right? So now the charging capacitor, which is the in sense of the current, how the variation of the current with respect to the T. So therefore, the current is the rate of change of charge. So therefore, here the current equation already we found by using of the previous equations. So E by R or V by R into E power minus T by R. See, the second equation means the current in the circuit is initially maximum, and then as the time passes by, it goes to zero once the capacitor is fully charged. So therefore, it is the resultant graph of the current versus time. So here, this is the current point, you say, which is the decay. The previously charge is exponential growth, it is exponential decay. So therefore, here the at the certain extent, the tau at the RC, which is the 0.368 I naught. So this is about the charging of a capacitor in the RC circuit. So you take, this is the equivalent circuit of the RC to circuit charging capacitor, which is in the capacitor resistance is connected in series with the voltage when the switch will be operated. If we'll take, that is about the charge. If we'll come into the discharge, when the fully charged the capacitor and it should be opened, the switch, and therefore the capacitor is fully charged and it's the plates switch is open and the no current flows through this. So automatically there is no current flows through this because the switch is open here, the open circuit. So therefore current is zero at the T is less than zero, that means the before switching the time. So therefore here this is the discharge, how it should be there actually. The switch is closed, the capacitor is being discharged, the current flows through that. So therefore like this, this is the discharging, which is the arrow mark indicated here, yellow marks, which is the minus Q to the plus Q. So like this, this is the closed circuit discharge of the capacitor, and the RC discharge capacitor is the capacitor fully discharged, no more current flows through this, okay. So therefore here fully discharged, then current should not pass in the circuit because of fully discharged, and you are going to take the Kirchhoff's loop rule. So therefore minus Q by C, minus of I into R is equal to zero, because the closed circuit, the algebraic sum of the total voltage drops, which is equal to zero. So therefore here you used to take minus Q by C is the voltage across the capacitor and the voltage across the resistor, which is indicated by the IR. So therefore here minus Q by C is equal to IR. So the circuit, again you used to take a Kirchhoff's loop rule, then you will take instead of I, you say that the dq by dt. So therefore minus Q by C minus of dq by dt into R, which is equal to zero. This is the first order equation, already know that. So again you used to take the Q by C is here, the time constant is 1 by R, okay. So now you take a differential equation, you need to better calculate skills, you are applied here. So therefore how you are take this, already know dq by dt is equal to minus Q by RC, you see that. So again you used to take the Q of t is equal to Q e power minus t by RC directly, right, Q into e power minus t by RC. So therefore minus 1 by RC is there, so therefore you said d minus 1 by RC is there, that's why you used to take a Q into e power minus t by RC. This is the differential equation solution, which is Q. Here already you know that the Q, I is equal to the Q dq by dt. So therefore I of t is equal to dq by dt, then d by dt of Q of e minus t by RC. Again you used to take the Q as a constant and differentiating with respect to the t. So therefore here e power minus t by RC, which is the differentiating, minus 1 by RC into e power minus t by RC. So therefore the final answer is minus Q by RC into e power minus t by RC. This is about the difference between the charging and discharging of the RC circuit in the discharging of the capacitor in the RC circuit. So now you take, this is the final solution for the Q of t is equal to Q into e power minus t by RC. The charge in the capacitor decreases with time, and you say that the current, so dq by dt, which is equal to d by dt of Q into minus t by RC, which is equal to minus Q by RC into e power minus t by RC. Current also decreases with the time, charge in the capacitor decreases with time, as well as the current also decreases with the time. So this is the discharging capacitor in the RC circuit. If we'll come into the charging in the RC circuit, means the charge is exponentially increases, but the current is exponentially decay. But here in the discharge point of view, the both will be decreases with respect to the time. So this is the actual discharge and charge summaries of the capacitor in the RC circuit, which is used to take here the Q of t is equal to Q into 1 minus e power minus t by RC, and if that is for the charging. If we'll come into this, the discharge, this is the Q of t equal to Q e power minus t by RC, which is in decreases with respect to the time, but in charging it is increases with respect to the time. And now we are coming to the currents, the charging and discharging of the capacitor in this RC circuit, both will be decreases with respect to the time. So it is the summary of the RC circuit. Now this is the very simple example to understand the RC network. So check this problem here. So you used to take, this is the circuit what they are given, the same similar circuit is there, R and C constants is there. So it have some values, that is R is equal to 1 mega ohm, and you say that C is equal to the 5 farads, and applied voltage is 30 volts. So you need to find what is the time constant of the circuit. You need to find the time constants of the circuit. That is the first question. And second question is the maximum charge on the capacitor after the switch is closed. The, what is the maximum capacitor, charge in the capacitor? And third one is if the switch is closed at the t equal to 0, find the current in the resistor 10 seconds later. So this is the three questions they were given according to this problem. So already we did the resultant equations of the related to the what is the charge and what is the what we call the current for the charging and the discharge circuits, discharge capacitance in the RC circuit. So you need to find it by using of the relations. Just I will give the little bit answer. The time constant of the circuit, you say that the R and C, R into C, that is called the time constant generally. You used to take RC is equal to 1 mega ohm into 5 farads. You say that that is the so you used to take, what is the time constant here, where 1 by RC, you say that. So this is R into C, this is the mega ohm, this is a farad. Now you take 5 into 1, right? So that is the which is in the seconds generally used to take. Okay, so now just to try yourself, otherwise I will tell this. And we will come into this, the RL circuit current growth. Here you say that the on a you say that this circuit have the capacitance, resistance, and you say that the two resistors is there, one capacitor is there. So what is the initial battery current immediately after switch S is closed, and what is the battery current a long time after the switch S is closed? So these two already I given in the previous video lectures, so we have to go through that and solve the problem. Okay, for the this is same. Yeah, now we will coming to this, the RL circuit. Similarly, same derivation you used to do that. So RL circuit current growth, you say that. So while the switch is closed, then the current passing through it, and the inductor should be open automatically, you know that. Because that is a zero plus, I mean the just switch over there, then the I of zero plus equal to zero. So therefore the current passing through it is zero generally. So the similarly used to take here, that is for the switching characteristics and all. Now you used to take here, the switch is closed, the current flows through the circuit, but it is delay by the inductor actually here. So now this is the switch is closed here, the yellow marks is there. This is R and L, which is passing through this. At the T extended to the infinite, that means the time greater than zero, then it acts as a short circuited. So therefore it is like this. So the current passing through the circuit. So now you used to take the Kirchhoff's loop law. You say that what is the Kirchhoff's loop rule means KVL. Kirchhoff's voltage law. How is the current passing through it? Just you have to observe that. And here you say the in between inductance in between the A and B terminals, you say that. So here what is the current passing through it? IR, that is the voltage drop across the resistance. and here voltage drop across the inductance, which is the LdA by dt. So therefore E minus of IR minus LdA by dt, which is equal to 0 from the circuit given, and used to take how the current will be growth in this. This is a V minus IR minus LdA by dt, which is equal to 0. Now I is equivalent to the, so similarly used to find the I, that I is equal to V by R into of 1 minus e power minus t by RC by using of the equation. Just to observe that now you used to take how the current how the current varying with respect to the time in the inductance, and the current starts at 0 at t equal to 0, current starts at 0, increases at as the time passes through this. So just to observe that this is exponential increases, the tau is equal to L by R, right? So similarly used to take here, just to observe, this is about the RL circuit current decay, how the switch S is closed, S2 is open. Just we will take the two switches is there here, RL circuit, switch S1 is closed and S2 is open. The current flows through the RL circuit through S1 only. So after some time the current becomes the maximum, I is equal to V by R, because L is a short circuited after some time. So therefore T tends to infinite, like, so therefore it is the maximum current flows through this. I is equal to V by R. And similarly used to take for this, this is the circuit which is S1 is over. Now we will coming to this. Yeah, if you will observe that S2 is closed and S1 is open, how the signal is passing? It says switch S1 is opened and S2 is closed, the current flows through the RL circuit through S2. So just to observe that how the current passing through the RL circuit is through S2, you say, like this. And coming to this, this is the how the current passing through it. The current decreases, but the diminishing rate is reduced by the presence of the inductance. Okay, due to the inductance presence, it may be rate should be reduced automatically. So this is the current delay in the RL circuit. Now you used to take, this is the by using of the Kirchhoff's voltage law, you say that how the current what is the closed circuit algebraic sum, which is equal to 0 generally, but the closed circuit is forming here only A, B and A. This is the loop only through S2 only, not through the S1. So therefore the drop across the resistance and drop across the inductance, the sum is equal to 0. So therefore here minus IR minus LdA by dt is equal to 0. From this relation, just we will take, this is the RL circuit current delay. So I is equivalent to the how we are going to take, this is T minus R by L generally used to take. So therefore that is the delay, current decreases as the time passes, but not instantaneously 0. So the I is equal to V by R e power minus t by tau, right? T by tau. So therefore here used to take generally how the current is varying with respect to the time in this is, you say that the decreases. So this is about the RL circuit. Now you are going to do somewhat problems here. Just to observe that, calculate the resistance of RL circuit in which the L is equal to 2.5 and the current increases 90% of its final value in the 3 seconds, you say that. So therefore what is that the response R by L, what is the time constant, you say that here. So that is L by R, you say, just like that you may do the problem. And similarly you say that 12 volts battery connected into a series circuit containing the 10 ohm resistor and the 2 Henry inductor, how long it will take the current to reach the 50% and the 90% of its final value. So for this you may do by using of the current, this is the I naught into e power minus t by t formula, where V and R values already know that this is the current delay, how you are going to find. And you may take another, say that only switch 1 is there. Yeah, this is the I is equal to V by R into 1 minus e power minus t by R. So here already know that the tau is equivalent to the L by R. Tau means that is the time constant which is the in inductance. So here you used to take for the given problem, the first problem you say that what is the L by R, you know that. So therefore tau is equal to L by R, that is the 2.7. That is the 90, increases the 90% of its final value 3 seconds. So therefore tau is equal to the L by R, R is equal to L by tau. Then by using our formula you may calculate it. And similarly these problems also by using those formulas, which is for the homework for you. And these also homework, just we have to do all these things, the RC and RL circuits. Now we are going to see for the LC circuits. Here the one thing is there, the two components which are L and C, both are the energy stored elements, already know that. Generally used to take these circuits used in a communication system, because in a radio receivers always we consider a local oscillator which is LC circuit. So therefore LC oscillators is there, generally used to take a Colpitts oscillator and the Hartley oscillator, which is also designed by using of these LC networks, right? And as well as the tuned collector amplifier, this is also used in LC networks. Like you say that this is the LC network, how the connection will be there, already know that this is the capacitance, which is one side of the positive and other side of the negative plates. You say the minus Q and plus Q max, and in between that the at the time t equal to 0 and I is equal to 0, if you will take the inductance L, already know that this is LC circuit, this is called the tuned circuit. So here you used to take the LC circuit which we have the inductance, already know that the properties of the capacitor inductance. So you used to take the LC 1 by 2 pi root LC, generally that is the frequency of oscillations and all for the different oscillators, like what we call Colpitts oscillator and even Wien-Bridge oscillator, like that. So this tuned circuit provides somewhat what we call the phase shift also in oscillator circuits. These the LC circuits, you say that how the minus Q and plus Q, and in between the voltage V or E, you say that, and the I current pass through it is 0. And the LC circuit, you say the omega is equal to 1 by root LC. Just now I told the oscillating charge, the oscillating current, you say that omega is 1 by root LC, where omega is the 2 pi FC. So F is equivalent to, or FC equivalent to the 1 by 2 pi root LC, that is the frequency of oscillations, where you say that Q is equal to Q max and the cos omega t, like that. So you used to take, this is the LC circuit, generally you used to take the oscillator initiating a charged when the switch S1 is opened and S2 is closed. The switch S1 is then thrown, closed at the same instant that the S2 is opened, so that the capacitor is connected directly across the inductor. Find the frequency of the oscillations. Already know that the values of capacitor and the inductor, just you have to go through that. That is the what they are given, the values of the inductor and capacitors. According to that you may just you observe that here this is the inductor is the 2.81 millihenries and the capacitor is 9 picofarads. F is equal to 1 by 2 pi root LC formula, you may apply these two values and find the frequency of the oscillation of the circuit. So now you used to take, this is the AC circuit, how the oscillations will produce like this voltages. The effective voltage and the current, you say the IRMS effective voltage, which is measured by the using of any what we call ammeter, milliammeter or microammeters, or you say that here the voltmeters, or you say multimeter here. So this is the IRMS, and the IRMS which is equal to the I max by root 2, which is the 0.707 of the I maximum value. And similarly used to take for the delta VRMS, which is also 0.1 by root 2 of the delta V max. So similarly used to take the average power, which is I square R formula, already know that IRMS square into R. So now you used to take effective voltage and currents like this, and this is the form. You say that I max and the IRMS and the VRMS, which is relates with the maximum current and voltage respectively. So these all are the problems for you. You have to do somewhat homework. Good example, you say that an LC circuit consists of a 20 millihenry inductor and the 0.5 microfarad capacitor. If the maximum instantaneous current is 0.1 amp, what is the frequency of the current oscillations? So f is equal to 1 by 2 pi root LC directly. What the greatest potential difference across the capacitor? So you need to find the voltage also. What is the greatest voltage across the capacitor? Just you have to VC, you need to find these two values, and you have to same similar problems is there. You may do yourself in house. Thank you very much for keep watching this lecture.